Hello friends, we are studying working of DC motor. DC motor works on the principle current carrying conductor in uniform magnetic field exert a force which works on Fleming's left hand rule. Before to study how this arm of the armature coil AB is moves in and out. This is the armature coil ABCD. Arm AB is connected to S1 part of this split ring. Split ring is that ring which is split up into conducting and non-conducting part. For example, this part is a conducting, this part is conducting, remaining part is non-conducting. So the ring is split up into conducting and non-conducting part. So it is called a split ring. When current from positive terminals of source of electricity, the conventional current flow from positive terminal to B1. B1, B2, these are brushes. Brushes provide the current to this armature coil. So current passes from B1 to S1 part of split ring to A to B. Now current flowing upward direction. Direction of magnetic field is along the forefinger and middle finger shows direction of flow of current. Then thumb shows the force act on this conductor. For example, this is my left hand. According to Fleming's left hand rule, this forefinger denote the direction of magnetic field. This middle finger shows the direction of flow of current and my thumb shows the direction of force acting on the conductor. Where my thumb is out of plane, so this conductor is pushed out. Here, the direction of current flow in upward direction, magnetic field, uniform magnetic field is from north pole to south pole. Where is my thumb? Inside the plane. So this arm AB is pushed in. The same current passes to C to D. Now the current flowing downward direction. According to Fleming's left hand rule, the forefinger shows direction of magnetic field. Middle finger shows direction of current which goes downward. My thumb is out of plane. So this arm is pushed out. See, this arm is pushed out and this gives a 90 degree rotation to this armature coil. At 90 degree rotation to this armature coil, this non-conducting part is come in front of brush B1 and B2. This non-conducting part is come in front of B2. So no current flow through the armature coil, but because of the rotational inertia, it completing remaining half, remaining 90 degree. And after 180 degree rotation, this space is occupied by the arm DC. This space is occupied by the arm A after 180 degree rotation. Again, this S1 conducting part of split ring is come in contact with brush B1. S2, thus conducting part of split ring is come in contact with brush B2. Then current flow from positive terminal to B1 to S2 to arm DC. So current flow in upward direction. From D to C. Again, according to Fleming's left hand rule, this middle finger shows direction of current, forefinger shows direction of magnetic field, where is my thumb? Inside the plate. This arm CD is pushed in. The same current is passes from C to A to B. The direction of current is again downward direction. The direction of magnetic field is remains same, current going downward direction. My thumb is out of plane. So this arm AB is pulled out. So every time any arm near to south pole is always pushed out. Any arm near to north pole always pushed in. In this way, it remains rotating continuously. Thank you for watching this video. For more such videos, check the description below. Like, share and subscribe to our channel.